Howdy y'all, and welcome to Lex Lives. I think it's time we play a little better than Wolves. So I have been working for a couple hours now on this thing, and I have actually gotten some squids to go through. Obviously not down here, but over in the other parts. Obviously, also some of my time has been taken up by running back from where I died and got teleported out to Northeast Island. 'Cause you know me, I can't survive more than a couple of hours without getting killed. He was really cheaty too. They brought in a couple of skeletons while I was swimming, and then I couldn't get out of the water fast enough to get away from two skeletons to stay alive. Because, you know, obviously, while you're in the middle of the water, skeletons gotta just appear in the water. I'm sure they came in from land, and I just didn't see them coming, but still, it was irritating. But this is a huge project. Like I said, I've been digging for. I've gone through three shovels, I think, at this point. And. I went through two iron shovels and a diamond shovel. So this is my second diamond shovel for the day. And, this is my second pickaxe, although I did upgrade to a diamond and got Unbreaking 2 Efficiency 2 on it, so that's really helpful. But since this does appear to work, I am going to expand it so I can get more squid coming through it. And what I'm working on right now is digging out the territory here where the hoppers will be to collect the leftovers. But I did see some squid spawn in my little 5x5, so that was good. Well, it was a 7x7 with a 5x5 on the bottom, anyways. This one's gonna be gigantic. This is gonna be 21x21 when it's all done. Much larger than what I had before. It's gonna take hundreds of hoppers, right? No? I think that works out to be. Maybe not. I don't know. Who knows math? Let's see. Two. One and one. I don't know. It's gonna be a lot. Let's just put it that. 5x5 is 25, 7x7 would be 49, and this is 9 times that. So, yeah, it's gonna be several hundred hoppers. Oh, really? Really? Is it gonna be that many hoppers? One of these days I'm gonna learn to do math in my head. I can do math in my head. I'm actually pretty good at it. I just can't do math in my head while talking and playing Minecraft at the same time. Just doesn't work out. But it should be like 232 hoppers or something like that. That's not several hundred. 232 hoppers. Man. If I didn't need the squid to fall and die, then I could use water to cut down on the number of hoppers pretty easily. But I can't have squid fall and die and drop their stuff because squid can survive in the water, and I don't want them to survive in the water. The way this will work now, though, is the squid will spawn, and then when it gets daytime, they'll swim down, and when they get to the bottom, they'll hit my vine traps, which means I'm gonna need like 231 vine traps. And then they'll all drown. Or suffocate, not drown, suffocate. And then I will get free stuffs. Alright, I gotta take another load of cobblestone back here. I've been running the cobblestone back so that I can make sure I get the supplies turned into stone for when I decorate the sides here. What did I just do? I ran around in a circle. Where's the way out? Okay, the way out is there. I don't know what I just did there. That doesn't work. Why would you think this would work? That was a dumb idea. Let's do this. Yay. I also had a zombie get in with my pigs and break open the door and maybe kill a pig. I'm not sure. I think the pigs took off running and he tried to chase the pig and it didn't work out in his favor because then I came and killed him. So I've blocked off the front of my barn there so nobody can get in. Yeah, that wasn't on here. I was thinking, man, someplace else today I got in a cave full of creepers and stuff and zombies and things like that. Oh man, I am like overwhelmed with the amount of supplies I've just shoved in here. Here, why don't you take this stone and some of this glass. Oops. Not you. You can go up there. Do I have any iron on me? I don't. Alright. And then, why don't you go ahead and take the rest of this cobblestone. And you can have some of that coal. But, yeah, this should be pretty awesome when it gets done. I mean, I imagine it's going to be kind of a slow build, but me not having to be there to fight the squid is a big plus. I mean, look at the size of this thing here. Let me get up on a hill here. I was fighting some spiders, too. Aw, dang it. Will you get out of here, skeleton? But that is going to be the size of my new squid trap when I'm done. Which, as you can see, is much larger than the previous squid trap. I'm not sure why that skeleton is inside the squid trap, though. Because he shouldn't be... But it's coming along. I know, I'm like, oh, look, we get to watch me dig some more stone out. But that's all I've got to do today. So, that's what we're going to do. I did have to play around with the old wither in the nether on my trip back. I couldn't find my path. I remember I had a path out of there. And I wound up traveling out and around and past the ghasts and blocking off lava, and I had to break the netherrack with my bare hands to finally get back into a path where I could get back to the farm here. I should have just went over land. It would have been easier if I had just gone over land, I think. It would have taken longer, though. And I guess I prefer not to take longer. But, yeah. Oh, you know, I was going to go inside here and show you. I did get some supplies. Bloop, one ink sack. That's all I managed. I think the rest of the squid must have fell down over here and died. That's how it goes. But, yeah. I haven't got any mysterious glands. Oh, I updated to the new version, too. I read what the update notes were the other day when Wired told me there was an update, and it didn't look like it was anything that was going to affect me directly. I mean, it changes the way the game works, obviously, but it didn't seem like anything too particular on what I'm doing. all my machines seem to still be working, so that's the important thing, right? Gotta make sure to keep those machines working. I think I've been sitting here quiet too long today. My throat is feeling a little scratchy. Not that they're still gone, but everybody was gone to fundraiser today for the school. They were having a pie auction and pie eating contest and some kind of school fair thing. Nothing that I need to attend. Although I was invited, I did get a Facebook invite from the school. It's a school that I went to school at, and so they do a big fundraiser every fall for extracurricular activities. I think that's what they were doing them for. New sports uniforms and things like that. School trips. All the stuff I hated. I hated fundraisers. Ugh. I'm like, just tell me how much my stuff's gonna cost and I will buy my stuff. But that's not the point of the thing. You gotta show school spirit by going out and annoying strangers by asking them to buy a fruit. I was actually ran into a couple of kids from different schools this week who were out doing their fundraisers, and I wound up with well, I didn't wind up with anything. I didn't have any cash on me, so they were out of luck. I don't normally carry cash, but one of them asked me if I wanted to buy I was gonna say fundraiser. I didn't want to buy a fundraiser. Asked if I wanted to buy a first aid kit. Was like, sorry, I don't have any cash on me, or checks. I don't carry checks. They're like, we can write a check. I don't carry my checkbook with me. Everything is swipe. You have your fundraiser with a card swiper, and I totally buy stuff from you. But I've yet to have the kids show up with the card swiper. That would probably make them more money if they had a card swiper. If I have cash on me, it's usually for a specific reason. I just don't carry cash. I don't do anything. I mean, what? If I need gas, card swipe. If I'm getting some lunch, card swipe. If I'm buying groceries, card swipe. Go to the movies, card swipe. I don't eat out, so there's no tips or anything. I think you can card swipe those most of the time now, too. Fundraisers, man, you guys gotta catch up. Gotta get the card swipers. Give it the times. Or, like, have your kids hand out cards. There you go. That lead to the website where you can get on and purchase there. Or, ooh, just have your kids carry tablets. And they can enter their information right there on the tablet. You need a swiper. You can just do it through the internet. I might actually buy some things if it was through the internet. Although it was really funny. I got asked if I wanted to buy a first aid kit for something. It had something to do with school. I just don't remember what it was supposed to be a fundraiser for. And that's the first time I've ever been asked if I wanted to buy a first aid kit as a fundraiser. But the other one was fruit and nuts, which is pretty normal. And he's telling me all the fruit stuff that they got and the nut stuff, and one of the things was one of the things is you want to buy caramel covered nuts dipped in chocolate milk, he said. Chocolate milk. I'm like, what? I'm like, wouldn't that be really messy? He's like, what do you mean? I'm like, chocolate milk? He's like, oh, no, milk chocolate. I'm like, well, that's what I figured it was, but that made me actually laugh. I hope I didn't hurt his feelings, but dude, that was funny. And I'm like, well, what kind of nuts are they? And he's like, it doesn't say. I'm like, well, how do I know if I'm gonna like it or not if it doesn't say what kind of nuts are in the caramel covered milk chocolate dipped nuts? Just that's pretty random not to tell me what kind of nuts are in there. And there wasn't, it didn't list anywhere what kind of nuts. It just said nuts. Here's your caramel covered milk chocolate dipped walnuts. That wouldn't be good at all. Blech, I hate walnuts. My nieces also hit me up for a fundraiser here not too long ago. And I think one was for volleyball uniforms and the other one was just a general fund for school expenses, like for trips and stuff. It wasn't for the school, it was for the individual students. I think, yeah. Get too crazy here breaking out my own blocks here without picking them up. I don't want to have to remake those stone blocks. Get some torches down here so nothing comes to get me. I should probably dig this floor out one more deeper so I can put torches underneath. Yeah, they were selling things I'm more interested in, like, well, no, that's not true. Cookie dough. I usually buy the cookie dough, at least a box or two. And I bought a mixed box this time. Usually I get specific kinds, but they had a mixed box, which was kind of a misnomer. It was. Chocolate nutty something is what it was called, and so I bought that box because it was supposed to be different kinds of chocolate nutty cookies, and then it's a chocolate cookie and a macadamia nut cookie. I'm like, that's not really what you said in your title, but whatever, they taste all right. My family does homemade cookies, and so store-bought cookies aren't as good as the homemade cookies ever. Not that we get macadamia nut cookies homemade, but there's just something off to me about store-bought cookies. There's like a weird flavor to them. Seems to be in all store-bought cookies. Must be preservatives or something. I'm sure it's not preservatives. I'm sure it's like the sugar content or something just doesn't cut it for me. All right, I'm gonna throw out some of this stuff so I can pick this up. And then the other thing they were selling was cups. And but they're tiny cups, 16-ounce cups. I'm like, I don't drink coffee. And this is bigger than a coffee cup anyways, but I don't drink coffee. And I normally just drink water, and I've got a really big glass that I put my water in. And so 16 ounces is like nothing. And I'm like, the only thing I drink that's even close to 16 ounces is I have a Mountain Dew usually every day. That's my beverage of choice. But usually only one Mountain Dew a day. And it's 16.9 ounces for the size of the bottles I drink. And this is a 16-ounce cup. I can't even put my Mountain Dew in this cup. And then on top of that, I don't do sports of any kind. I don't watch sports. I don't enjoy watching sports. It's just not my thing. And so the cups were school sports teams, like college sports, I think, maybe. And so I wound up with a pink a pink cup with owls on it because it was the only non-sports cup available in the fundraiser. All right, I think we better get this from the inside. Man, look at this space I've cleared out though. This is huge. This is all gonna be for squid killing. Whoops. Well, I guess that's not a whoops. I'm taking that out anyways. It just wasn't my intention at the moment to break down the glass. Why are you digging so slow? Dig it out. I also ran into some. What are those guys called? I can't think what they're called. Little insect dudes that live in the stone. Silverfish. And for the longest time, one was just making his little silverfish noise down there, and I could not find him. I dug and dug and dug and could not find him. And now I've dug all this out, and I don't hear him anymore, but I don't know where he went to. Which is bizarre to me. Whatever. You go do your thing, silverfish. But yeah, they do like a fair and pie auction every year for my the school I went to in high school. And well, that wasn't a thing when I was there though, not as a student. That's a new thing that they do. They never had anything like that when I went there as a student. We sold oranges. That's what I remember. I hate oranges. In fact, if the smell of oranges is strong enough, it makes me sick to my stomach. And I remember being in high school, and every year the semi full of oranges would come to the school, and they'd get volunteers to go out and unload the semis. Usually be a couple of them full of oranges and grapefruits and stuff like that, and then the whole building would just reek of orange smell. Gross. Oh, and not only that, but then you'd have to go through the boxes because some of the oranges would be damaged in shipping, and so you'd have to go through all the boxes and make sure that nobody got bad oranges, and so somebody would have to pick out all the bad oranges, which just made it smell even worse. It's very gross. Well, I think this gives you an idea of the size of my squid farm is going to be once I get it all done. So I'm going to go ahead and call it here. And I'll probably. I want to say I'll get more done before next episode. I want to say it. But it'll depend on how busy I get. So. Anyways, I think it'll be cool once I get it done, and then it can start getting me supplies, like my chicken farm was getting me supplies, and then maybe I can get down and do some caving one of these days, get some more gold, and try and get myself some. I wonder where that dude was at, all freaking out. Try and get myself some more things built around the farm here that I'd like to get done. I'd like to get some iron doors up on things to keep the zombies out. And I'd like get my automated pig killer going. That's something I really want to get done, is the automated pig killer. And maybe the automated cow killer. I'd like to get one of those too, just so I have a consistent supply of leather and stuff. But yeah, pretty crazy. It's a lot of work today. All right, click like if you like. Subscribe if you're sure and catch the next one, and I will talk to you later.